بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In this chapter, I will discuss temporal and infratemporal fossa and their contents including muscle of mastication, mandibular nerve, maxillary nerve, maxillary artery, otic ganglion, temporomandibular joints, and also I will discuss trigopalatine fossa and its contents including sphenopalatine ganglion. The temporal fossa, it is a narrow fan-shaped space that covers the lateral surface of the skull. Its upper margin is defined by a pair of temporal lines, but temporal lines superior to the temporal fossa. It is limited laterally by the temporal fascia, which overlying the temporalis muscle. Anteriorly, it is limited by posterior surface of the frontal process of the zygomatic bone and the posterior surface of the zygomatic process of the frontal bone. Its inferior margin is marked by the zygomatic arch laterally and by infratemporal crest of the greater wing of the sphenoid medially. The floor of the temporal fossa is open medially to the infratemporal fossa and laterally to the region containing the masseter muscle. يبقى الفلور بيفتح على الانفراتمبرال فوسا. The infratemporal fossa is a wedge-shaped space deep to the masseter muscle and underlying ramus of the mandible. Structures that travel between cranial cavity, neck, trigopalatine fossa, floor of the oral cavity, floor of the orbit, temporal fossa, and superficial regions of the head pass through it. Communication of the infratemporal fossa. The infratemporal fossa communicate with number one with the temporal fossa through gap deep to the zygomatic arch. Number two, communicate with the trigopalatine fossa through trigomaxillary fissure. Number three, communicate with the orbit through inferior orbital fissure. Number four, communicate with the nasal cavity through the sphenopalatine foramen. Muscle of mastication. Number one, temporalis muscle. Origin of temporalis muscle. It originates from the bony surface of the temporal fossa. Number two, from the inferior temporal line. Number three, from the fascia covering the temporalis muscle. Insertion of the temporalis. The temporalis muscle attached down to the anterior surface of the coronoid process of the mandible and along the related margin of the ramus of the mandible almost to the last molar tooth. Nerve supply. The temporalis muscle is innervated by deep temporal nerves that originate from the mandibular nerve in the infratemporal fossa and then pass into the temporal fossa. Action of the temporalis. The temporalis muscle is a powerful elevator of the mandible. Number two, the posterior fibers of the temporalis also retract the mandible or pull it posteriorly. In addition, the temporalis participates in side-to-side movement of the mandible. The second muscle of mastication, the masseter muscle. Origin of the masseter. The masseter has two head, superficial part and deep part. The superficial part of the masseter originate from the maxillary process of the zygomatic bone and the anterior to third of the zygomatic process of the maxilla. The deep part of the masseter originate from medial aspect of the zygomatic arch and the posterior part of its anterior margin. Insertion of the masseter. The superficial part inserted into the angle of the mandible and related posterior part of lateral surface of the ramus of the mandible. The deep part inserted into central and upper part of the ramus of the mandible as high as the coronoid process. Nerve supply of the masseter. The masseter is innervated by the masseteric nerve from the mandibular nerve. Action of the masseter. The masseter muscle is a powerful muscle of mastication that elevates the mandible. The third muscle of mastication, lateral pterygoid. Origin. The lateral pterygoid muscle is a six triangular muscle and has two heads. The upper head originates from the roof of the infratemporal fossa, inferior surface of the greater wing of the sphenoid, and the infratemporal crest, lateral to the foramen ovale and foramen spinosum. The lower head is larger than the upper head and originates from the lateral surface of the lateral plate of the pterygoid process. Insertion of lateral pterygoid. Lateral pterygoid inserted into pterygoid fovea of the neck of the mandible and into the capsule of the temporomandibular joint in the region where the capsule is attached internally to the articular disc. يبقى الانسرشن عندنا in three sites: pterygoid fovea, الكبسول of the temporomandibular joint, and the articular disc within the joint. Nerve supply of lateral pterygoid. The lateral pterygoid is innervated by the nerve of lateral pterygoid, which is a branch from the anterior division of mandibular nerve. Action of lateral pterygoid pulls the articular disc and the head of the mandible forward onto the articular tubercle and is therefore the major protruder of the lower jaw. We can summarize the action number one by that the lateral pterygoid opening the mouth. Number two, the lateral and the medial pterygoid contract only on one side. The chin move to the opposite side. Action number three, medial and lateral pterygoid of one side contracting alternatively with that of opposite side, producing side-to-side movement or showing movement. Relations of lateral pterygoid, superficial relations. Number one, masseter. Number two, ramus of the mandible. Deep relations. Number one, trunk of mandibular nerve and its branches. Number two, middle meningeal artery. Number three, accessory meningeal artery. Number four, third part of maxillary artery. Number five, sphenomandibular ligament. Number six, deep head of medial pterygoid. Number seven, corda tympani. Structures emerging at the upper border of lateral pterygoid. Two deep temporal nerves, nerve to masseter. Structures passing between the two heads. Maxillary artery enter between the two head. Buccal branch of the mandibular nerve comes out between the two heads. Structures emerging at the lower border of lateral pterygoid. Number one, lingual nerve. Number two, inferior alveolar nerve. Finally, we must mention that the maxillary artery either superficial or deep to the lateral pterygoid muscle. The last muscle of mastication is the medial pterygoid muscle. The medial pterygoid muscle is quadrangular in shape and has deep and superficial heads. Origin of the medial pterygoid. The deep head is attached above to the medial surface of the lateral plate of the pterygoid process and the associated surface of the pyramidal process of the palatine bone. The fibers of this head descend obliquely downward medial to the sphenomandibular ligament. The superficial head originates from the tuberosity of the maxilla and the adjacent pyramidal process of the palatine bone. Insertion of the medial pterygoid. The medial pterygoid inserted into roughened medial surface of the ramus of the mandible near the angle of the mandible. Nerve supply of the medial pterygoid. The medial pterygoid is innervated by nerve to the medial pterygoid from the mandibular nerve. Action of the medial pterygoid. Number one, the medial pterygoid mainly elevates the mandible because it passes obliquely backward to insert it into the mandible. Number two, it also assists the lateral pterygoid muscle in protruding the lower jaw. Number three, side-to-side movement with lateral pterygoid